A while back, I was asked if I wanted to join a large collab of game devs remaking the Mario Party mini games. Obviously, I said yes. Now, nearly everyone in the collab was making their games in Unity, but if you don't know me, I'm too good for those fancy schmancy game engines, and instead I like to make my games in things that don't really have any business being game engines, like making 2048 in Discord, or making this weird Hangman and Snake hybrid game in Excel. For this game, I'll be staying true to that sentiment, but I'll actually be picking something that might actually be good and viable for a game engine in the near future, as I'll be making this game in Go and WebAssembly. Because of this, I wanted to make sure I chose a game that wasn't too complex, and was also good for me to remake in this environment. And after looking over the list, I settled upon the game Shy Guy Says, not only because of the rule set, pretty easy to understand, but also because Shy Guy is the best Mario character, don't at me. So this all sounds good and all, but there's just one problem. I've never written a single line of Go in my life, nor have I ever utilized WebAssembly. Basically, what I'm trying to say is not only was this a project that was way too advanced for me because I've never utilized Go or WebAssembly, but also because I decided to make this a fully online, multiplayer-supported game. Because of this, my early work on the game was very slow, riddled with errors, and basically understood almost nothing about the code I was writing. It is because of that I owe a huge shout out to one of my mods, A_D, who is my resident Go guru, and basically babied me through this whole project and made me look actually somewhat competent to do this. So big thanks to him. Also, this whole process, failures and all, was streamed live over my Twitch, so definitely check me out there to see what projects I am currently working on. Okay, enough talking, let's get to some actual code, shall we? I started by first learning how to make a WASM file from Go and load it into the browser. I decided to use a canvas to draw the game output to, and soon learned that this just meant making a bunch of JavaScript code calls through Go, which felt a bit roundabout, but oh well. Once I had the webpage rendering and drawing some basic squares that changed based upon my input, it was time to get started on some game logic. From the get-go, I had planned to make this all an online multiplayer game using WebSockets, and thought it'd be a great idea to learn Go by implementing the said WebSockets. It wasn't totally a bad decision, but I was in way over my head as it was, so a lot of the initial work was just Googling, copying, and editing code, and lots of wishful thinking. Luckily though, after a lot of help, I was able to get the WebSockets connected and sending data between them. I put this to the test by sending my inputs to the server, which successfully changed my user shown flag. Next up, it was time to write a lot of code to create all the logic and packets necessary to support users joining, leaving, and handling different games, which I ended up calling rooms. Basically, when a user first visits the site, they need to enter in the display name they want to use, and then the name and optionally the password of the room they want to join. If they're the one creating the room, then they can simply hit the create button instead of the join. Each room has a max of 4 players, and it handles the logic to make sure that the packets only get sent to those in the room and not to everyone connected to the server. This definitely took a large part of the total time making it, but in the end I was very happy with how it all turned out, and joining and leaving logic actually worked very well. With the core logic out of the way, all I had to do was add some further game logic to control which flag the Simon character showed that the players would have to copy, as well as add the logic that changed the current state of the game. This also handles removing the players that lose in a given round by showing the incorrect flag, as well as determining when someone has won the game and when it should reset. I finished up with some polishing of the game logic and attempting to make the game scale in some sort of difficulty so that it wouldn't last forever. With the game logic completed, I was finally time to move on to revamping the UI and remove my developer assets. I decided to make everyone a penguin because one, penguins are amazing, but also because getting a cease and desist letter from Nintendo from using the actual Shy Guy character and other Mario Party characters is not something I want to deal with. I also added some nice animations to the raising and lowering of the flags, and voila, Shy Guy Says, remade as a web game using WebAssembly and Go. Now the gameplay is nothing all that amazing or entertaining, although nor was the original Mario Party minigame, so it's kinda whatever. At the end of the day though, it was great to learn how to utilize WebAssembly as well as learn Go, and I definitely developed a soft spot for it as a low level language, and it's one that I definitely want to get back to in the future videos to learn more about it. That's all I have for you guys today though. I know I didn't focus on the code a lot in this video, but this was filmed over a long period of time and at this point a while ago, so it was really hard for me to kind of sum up all I had done as well as kind of show off the code when it was so new to me and I was learning a lot, and a lot of it was just trial and error, so I apologize there. Anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed. Let me know what I choose as my next unconventional game engine down in the comments below. But that's it for me. I'll see you guys all next time. Peace out.